What's up, everybody? It's Man of Low Moral Fiber here. My name's Luke, and in this video, I am going to be farming Pete here at Overpower Level 8 with this legitimate Sniper Zero. So I have on my B shield. We're going to be using a Trespasser to knock off Pete's face mask, and then a Shock Lyuda in order to kill him. I do believe I have on a Shock Bone of the Ancients as well. We'll see how it goes. I do have the Chaotic Evil Rogue Comm on right now. I am going to be starting the fight, though, with a one-shot sniper comm on, because hopefully that will allow us to take off Pete's face shield in one shot of the Trespasser. I don't know if my B is strong enough for that, though. I do believe I have a perfect Trespasser as far as grip and accessory. Yeah, I think so. So the Trespasser is up to the task. I just don't know if the B shield is up to the task. So I'm going to go ahead and drop that particular comm, put on the one-shot sniper comm, and we will summon Pete. Okay, so now we want to wait almost until Deception's all the way over here and knock his face shield off. So that worked. We have on the right comm. Take out a little bit of his health. Make certain he's still slagged. And then we'll continue to take out his health, or his shield at the very least. His health comes next. Okay, we'll avoid this Nova like such, slag him like such, and build our critical ascension while we wait on the B, I guess. Oh shit. Well, that didn't work. There wasn't enough scaffolding there. So, we'll pop out of this thing. And then we'll kill these little guys. Little fellers. Okay. So that will also give me a little bit of sniper ammunition to now deal with this guy. Ooh, I do like this arms down running. Unfortunately, I didn't have my gun reloaded to fully take advantage of such a situation. We'll wait for his double Nova here. And then we should be able to, hopefully, get a kill on him. But I'm pretty low on ammo, so I don't know. We'll see. Eating up big chunks of his health now. Oh, that was bad. Got my shield eated for no reason, but he's still dead, so that's one kill. We'll take a look at what we've got. We should probably pick up the more valuable items for sale fodder. But right now, we're just going to pick up some Seraph Crystals and such. Here's the O negative we got. It's lobbed and it's a fire, so it kind of blows. We can pick up that to sell. Same with that thing. The Seraph Crystals could always be used to buy another Seraph item. I just don't have one that I know that I need right now. I picked up something there that I didn't want to. Alright, we'll ride the the elevator out of here, and then we'll check out the two red chests that are up where you would rescue Moxie if the story mission was going on. Obviously, it's not going on right now, and then we'll save quit and do the whole process over again a few times. See what type of legendary we get, perhaps. I'm debating going with a stockpile relic instead of the Bone of the Ancients because my Lyuda is so crappy. That would definitely give us a lot more ammo to spend. So, I was really hoping that one of those relics would have been a stockpile relic, but didn't turn out to be the case for us. That's okay, though. we'll go ahead and try again. Pete takes a lot longer to kill than the snowman, obviously. But you get Seraph Crystals, and there's a good opportunity for other items as well. We can just go ahead and sell those two things now that I am so low on money. I was doing some playing around earlier, and I spent a bunch of money on rocket ammo while I was firing some sort of... I think I found a Mongol. I forgot what it was, but I bought a bunch of rocket ammo, and then, yeah... Oh, it was actually that stupid Tunguska, I think. Yeah, it was. Okay. So, now we're going to come down here, and I'll be doing a Does It Suck video before long on the Tunguska, and we're going to fight this guy again. Oops, it's too late now to switch to a stockpile relic. What I should do is start with the stockpile relic and drop the Bone of the Ancients on the floor for maximum efficiency and such. But, meh. If I can get that spacing right with the Lyuda pellet split, then it wouldn't matter, because with the B and that and Critical Ascension and everything, you just really tear into him. It's just difficult to get that distance right, especially for any extended amount of time. Okay. So, we'll go ahead and call him in. Slag him up. Get the kunais on him. Oh, that's the wrong fucking weapon, Luke, you idiot. So this one's off to a really bad start. Neato. So I want to pretty quickly work my way over to the scaffolding. Lest we, get caught like that. So, this one's off to about as shitty a start as one could hope for. So that's kind of neat. We'll try to recover. Alright. So, we will begin building Critical Ascension now. And I disappear, a ghost amidst the combat, preparing to strike. We'll let that happen. Build up on the Critical Ascension a little bit. God, it's been a while since I fought Pete. Now he's in double Nova mode from here on out, and we'll need to be careful for that. But we're doing pretty okay on Critical Ascension, so we'll keep trying here. That sideways run he was doing was helping us stay in that optimal pellet split range. Unfortunately, that still wasn't enough not to need more ammo, but that's okay. Glad the game was generous there with that box. We should be able to kill this dude now. Even without washing off, maybe? I don't know. This is probably dangerous. We'll see. Interesting. Alright, what did we get this time? Some more Seraph Crystals, obviously. Got a blast-proof TDR shield. Another adaptive shield, a Hyperion amp shield, some more iridium, wonderful. Plenty of Seraph crystals, obviously. We're up above the 120 now that it costs to buy something. Still no orange items in two runs so far, but whatever. That is a resistance relic, which we don't need. we could theoretically get a better stockpile relic in doing this, so that would be pretty sweet. Oh, sticky longbow incendiary transfusion. Theoretically, we could get a better longbow slag transfusion, although it does seem unlikely. We're going to continue to look over this gear, head up to the chest upstairs, see what we get, and then we'll do it again. I don't know how many times we're going to want to kill Pete, but we'll kill him a few times. I'm getting pretty excited for the Olympics. I just worry about the state of affairs in Brazil and kind of how crazy things are worldwide right now. It would seem that the Olympics would be a target, but I'll try to remain optimistic and hope that everything just goes well. We will see. I worry about it, you know? So this is a longbow pandemic. I was laughing because, you know, we don't get an orange item from Pete, but we do get it from the chest up here, so that's kind of neato. None of those other grenades interest me at this time, so that's cool. Like I said, I hope the Olympics go off without a hitch, but I worry that they won't, especially since Brazil said they're trying to have their mass transit done like 4 days before the Olympics are set to start or something like that. That seems crazy to me personally, but you know, maybe they'll get it done. Maybe it'll be perfect. I hope it is. The Olympics are usually a very entertaining event, so I hope that's the case. There's kind of a TV dry spell right now, as far as I'm concerned. Aren't too many shows in season that I'm very interested in. Obviously, basketball's over, and it's still a significant amount of time till football starts. No current show in season on AMC that I'm interested in, be that Walking Dead, Fear the Walking Dead, Turn. Into the Badlands is one that I'm actually really looking forward to coming back. But, you know, it's a ways out as well. So, disappointing right now as far as television goes for me. But I have confidence that there'll be good stuff on television as soon as we get to the fall. Also, we're kind of in a drought as far as video games coming out as well right now. The summer drought, like after basketball and hockey ends, there's not a lot of entertainment in my mind. Regardless, we're getting ready to spawn Pete, so might as well get ready for that. Try to wait till the last moment here, and got him. First try, that was excellent. Because that causes him to run out his arms down, and we can get quite a few critical ascension stacks there. Try to avoid him here as far as his flame length. Okay, we'll let him shoot his globs, and then we will enjoy some arms down running at us. That'll cause him to Nova up again, and then we can go get our Bone of the Ancients here in just a moment. We'll have plenty of ammo. Cool. Excellent. So now I have my Bone of the Ancients on. He's slagged. He's running at us, arms down. We have a ton of ammo. We have a ton of critical ascension. This is going to be our best run yet, unless something goes catastrophically wrong. And it sure did for Pete. He just decided to take a seat right there without proceeding any further forward, which not really a good move for him. But that's okay. It works out for us. Looking through this stuff, this is a longbow shock singularity, but it has a high fuse time, so not useful to me at this point in time. I do have a quasar, so that works out. Let's see what this grenade over here was. Longbow incendiary with an even longer fuse time. Sticky longbow slag O negative, but it's only got 6 child grenades, and it's got a huge fuse time. So that sucks. It's not better than the one I already have. So that's a real shame. I do wish the O negative was available to buy from the Seraph vendor. That would make it a lot easier to farm for a suitable transfusion grenade. I don't know why exactly they made some Seraph items unviable at Ultimate Vault Hunter mode, but I do think that was a mistake. Pete's been vanquished a few times now. We'll continue to kill him. But first, we're going to go up here and check out these two chests. People do want a save file released for the Sniper Zero that I am playing. I will try to get that done here in the near future. I forget which site's best to upload save files to these days, but we'll find something that works. And in that video, I'll give you an overview of my skill build and why things are the way they are, since people ask for that as well. Looking at these grenades here, we didn't get anything that interests me, so we're going to go ahead, save, quit. Go back in, buy some ammo, rinse, lather, repeat over and over again. Definitely worked out a lot better actually having enough ammo to kill Pete this time, so that's good stuff. I would like to have a much better Shock Lyuda, but it does seem entirely unlikely that Pete would drop that. Perhaps we could do a Gettle farming episode before too long, throwback to the Journey to 100% and Level 1 to OP8 series there, where I did farm that weapon I'm actually holding in my hand. It seems so unlikely that we would get a better overpower level 8 Shock Lyuda. It's just so difficult to find the items that you're actually looking for in the elements you're actually looking for, which is kind of a shame. Put back on the stockpile relic there. That works for both of those item drops. I'm going to go ahead and put on the one-shot sniper comm. Perfect. Cool. So we took out a ton of his health there when we were at, or shield at least, when we were at the right range that the pellet split was causing multiple critical hits at once and everything. But it's hard to maintain that range on Pete because he moves faster than you can back up while shooting, at least. Okay. So, hopefully that slags him. I'm putting on this particular relic. He'll turn this way. And he will meet his impending doom. Eventually. He's got a lot of health. Okay. So another Pete down. Another non-legendary drop from Pete. I don't know how many times we have to kill Pete to get a legendary, but it hasn't happened yet. So there's a sticky lobbed incendiario negative. Obviously not what I'm looking for. So we will leave it be. Go ahead and call down this elevator. Make sure it doesn't crush me though while I pick up these Seraph crystals and such. So, the only legendary we've gotten so far is from the chest upstairs. We're obviously going to keep checking those out since Pete's not being super generous with us, but that's all right. Upstairs we go. Do much prefer killing Pete with perfect gear, but obviously, if you're gibbing your gear, there's really no reason to farm, so on this character, I don't gib. On other characters, though, I do find it to be more fun, just because you don't spend time looking for stuff when you could just have it. We'll pick that up to sell. We'll go again. That's kind of like a Norfleet that only shoots one orb type deal, that PBFG or whatever it is. Yeah, PBFG. Go ahead, put that on. You can see it just shoots one rocket thing like that, which is cool, but obviously not for us. Need to put on my relic. Perfect. Now hopefully on this Pyro Pete kill we can have the kind of run that we've had, you know, most recently rather than what we were starting out with. Now that we're actually doing the stockpile relic thing, I think that makes a huge difference. Wish I had a better stockpile relic, but that is another one of those items where it is just so difficult to farm for a specific type of stockpile relic. There needs to be something done to address that going forward in the Borderlands series, I think. Put back on the stockpile relic, drop that, go ahead, put back on that, watch where those items go. Perfect. Really? Huh. So, not going well here to start. I guess I should slag him. Alright. Run at me, fool. No! This guy sucks right now. Whatever. We'll get a fresh lease on this particular battle now. Go ahead and start building a little bit of critical ascension. Perfect. Want to get back to the scaffolding, though. We're gonna work his shield down eventually here. Perfect. Okay. So I'll lead him out here just a little bit. I didn't really mean to get my shield broken, but it shouldn't be of too much consequence. I really thought I'd break his shield there. There we go. Alright, so he's double Nova from here on out, so we want to kill him quickly if possible. We have an amount of critical ascension. It's not the highest, but we do have enough ammo. Alright, so right after this, he's gonna go into Nova mode again. Wanna make sure line of sight's broken with him. And that's good. Got plenty of ammo. Always a good thing. Got plenty of critical ascension. Always a good thing. And I got a dead Pete, which is, you know, a good thing. We'll continue to collect these Seraph crystals. And look at what else he dropped. This is definitely a longbow transfusion grenade. Purple. But I think it's shock. Oh, it's corrosive. Damn. Still. Decent grenade. I was really hoping it was going to be the perfect slag grenade. That would have made this so much better. But whatever. Continue to look around at what else he dropped. We got a hoplite shield. Not useful at overpower levels, obviously. So, this is really aggravating because that is... Is that better than my stockpile relic? No, that's exactly what my stockpile relic is. But, it's irritating to see not sniper rifle. When that's what I'm using and everything. Regardless, we'll head upstairs and check out those two chests, and then I'm thinking maybe one more Pete run after this will be perfect. We'll see. What a shame, though, that we're not getting exactly what we want. We get close sometimes, you know, as far as a better stockpile relic or a better grenade goes, but never really actually get it. I guess another thing we could farm for in the future is a better B shield, or, I don't know, a few things we could farm for. Definitely not worth coming up here this time, but whatever. This is a rubberized, non-elemental transfusion grenade. Ugh. That's terrible. Rubberized grenades are just always bad, but, you know, whatever. Stock up on ammo. We gotta do better on Pete this time. I feel like last time really went awry. But that's okay. Unfortunately, this is the world's slowest elevator. I don't understand why they would make that elevator slow. That would seem to just discourage farming. But whatever. Go ahead and drop this particular piece of gear and that one as well. Put that on and this on. Perfect. Get as many critical hits as I can there. Especially if he's just going to sit there. Ah, I thought he was just going to sit there for a moment. Sometimes he just sits there and, you know, does his arms back and forth and stuff, and that would have been really perfect to kill him. Especially after the good start we had and stuff. Regardless. Damn it. Trying to lure Pete over into this area, but I don't think that's going to block I thought I would maybe be able to block line of sight with him, but just seems unlikely now, doesn't it? That's okay. Assassins never die. I don't know why Pete decided to go non-aggressive there for a minute, but whatever. Still no legendary item from Pete, huh? My gosh. That's ridiculous. Another hoplite. We can sell that in a minute. Another purple item over here. It's a bandit pistol. No good. Not that it's necessarily bad, but it's just not useful for me. I've still got the water effect, which is nice. Zero is constantly taking a shower at this point. Oh, we got a Gentleman's Storm. So, we didn't get a legendary item, but we did get a pearlescent. So, now I can title the video Pearlescent from Pete or something along those lines. That'll be neato. I can even take a thumbnail right now. We can do toggle HUD. And then we can press this button a bunch of times. And look at that. Now we can do a thumbnail. It's going to have this sweet-ass water effect in it. I'll take the screenshot several times just so we can get that water effect. Maybe we get it like this, a different angle perhaps. But then my legendary item shows up in it, which is not ideal. A little bit deceptive, perhaps. Cool. Alright, we'll turn toggle HUD back on. I'll actually use two hands of type this time. And the order I want to pick these up in goes 1, 2, 3, 4. Perfect. We will pick that up. And that is about all she wrote for this particular video, other than checking those two chests up there. Pete was stingy as far as orange items go, but he did end up dropping us this Hyperion-gripped Gentleman's Storm. So, not a great weapon by any means, but it can be used effectively in the Pete fight if you have a large amount of critical ascension and then need to summon little spider ants to wash off or something. You can go like this and it kills all of those spider ants. So, it can be a useful weapon if you have a huge amount of critical ascension for killing small mobs. However, its uses are very niche, few and far between, absolutely. And even then, it's hard to justify situations. Oh, that finally made my water effect go away. It's hard to justify carrying this weapon as one of your four weapons because its potency is just not superb. Or, you know, really even on par with other snipers, so that's kind of a shame. Alright, so that's that, guys. As always, I thank you very much for watching. I do appreciate it. If you haven't yet taken the time to subscribe, please do so. I'd appreciate that as well. Otherwise, I do hope to catch you next time. Bye, guys.